J-Ray 501. Well, there's so much going on with the San Onofre nuclear generating station that it is mind-boggling. Let me say that. It's mind-boggling that Southern California Edison can't do the right thing and close down that plant. That's number one. Number two is the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, which from here on out will be called the Non-Regulatory Commission, doesn't seem to see what general public sees, and that is that this is a safety hazard and it is an accident waiting to happen, and no, nothing has been learned from Fukushima. And so that's another ongoing issue. Now we have the issue with the California Public Utility Commission, who is now being forced to look into why the ratepayers in Southern California have been bilked for $1 billion, paying for a plant that is crippled and non-operational. So they have a certain amount of time to get that plant up and running. If they pass that time period, then they have to pay. They have to pay all that money back to the ratepayers. So we've already hit that mark. That's why 6 months ago there was such a big push to restart the plant. And so it's been bogged down with getting the NRC involved and now the California Public Utility Commission. So this is actually phase one of the hearing, where they're trying to establish what they will be doing during each phase of this hearing. And so I'm going to run this clip. This is John Giesman. He's the attorney for the Alliance for Nuclear Responsibility. The judge speaking is Judge Melanie Darling. She is anything but what her name suggests. And you can see, just get a taste of how ridiculously inept the California Public Utility Commission is. Just like the NRC.
Thank you, Your Honor. John Giesman on behalf of the Alliance for Nuclear Responsibility. I would chime in with DRA, TURN, and the energy users as to the primary importance of addressing the legal aspects of taking the plant out of rights. I am somewhat confused by your distinction between phase one and phase two, and left unclear as to whether you would be prepared to make a decision on taking the plant out of rate base prior to phase two. The plant is neither used nor useful today, based on Mr. Craver's comments to investors in the summer. It would appear that Unit 3 has been abandoned altogether. My client is strongly of the belief that the plant under Section 455.5 should be taken out of rates immediately, and I am not clear as to whether your phasing between Phase 1 and Phase 2 would defer that decision unduly or not.
Well, 455.5 does direct the Commission to hold a hearing before removing anything from rate base. In order to do that, we have to have an evidentiary record which tells us which pieces of plant are no longer used and useful, and then make a decision about whether it's just and reasonable to remove it from rate base. One can't. Our view is that there needs to be a record in order to do that.
And that should be
where
they start.
We're starting with a record of finding out in phase one.
That should be the starting
point. What exactly happened? What actions did Edison take? What costs did they incur as a result of the shutdown? What costs did they avoid?
She's already got all of this information.
are not operating, what pieces are, and that gives us a basis to go into the rate-based discussion of under 455.5 as to whether it's reasonable to take out, remove, or eliminate from the value of certain pieces of plant.
Now let me just interrupt here for 1 second. The other issue is that Southern California Edison applied in 2012, applied for a rate increase. And I do believe they got it because they snuck it under the wire and it went through. So this is where this should be already, we should already have all of this done. All of this conversation that they're having right now, this should have already been taken care of. All of this information, they have. So why is she stalling on all of this? This is a determination to find out if Southern California Edison bilked everyone. It is obvious that they did. So, you know, this is business as usual, though.
So, to just simply say the plant's not operating, take a couple billion out, is not a responsible or an appropriate.
Right there, she admits, take a couple billion out. Right there, she clearly states what she knows. It's already been well over $1 billion.
Action. The purpose of this proceeding is to establish a very clear evidentiary record of what was done, what was spent, why, and what wasn't operating.
Your Honor, I certainly think that you should do that. What I'm not clear on is when you anticipate having developed the record and having had the briefing that would enable you to make a decision on whether the plant should come out of rates or not.
I think that our expectation is later this year.
Well, then I would indicate that the Alliance has a very strong concern as to the wisdom of deferring that decision for such a long time. Section 454.8, which does apply to new plants, makes very clear that the used and useful concept is intended to assure that ratepayers in a given year will not pay for the benefits received in other years. There is no way to rationalize what benefit the ratepayers have received from this plant in 2012, and from the sounds of it, no way to rationalize what benefit they may receive from 2013. And as a consequence, I think the Commission would be well advised to make as prompt a decision supported by an evidentiary record on whether the plant should come out of rates or not.
All right, thank you very much. Mr. Reed.
She just, thank you very much. Thanks for your opinion, but we don't care. Now, this next gentleman is Michael Aguirre. This poor man was shot down in the first 5 minutes of this meeting. But he does have some intelligence, and he does try to put her in her place and remind her of things that have already been listed that she seems to act like she doesn't know, or she's very put off that it's being put back up before her. Don't you remember this? And she is trying to control the situation. And you can tell she's getting very frustrated and very angry. Oh, Judge Darling.
There was a statement made by the NRC that said, due to modeling errors, the SONS replacement operations were not, generators were not designed with adequate thermal hydraulic margin to preclude the onset of fluid elastic instability. So there does seem to be a consensus that it was a design and modeling problem. May I just ask, just to cut to the quick, would it be Your Honor's intention that those design and modeling documents that are in SCE's possession, that those would be considered to be protected?
I'm not going to pre-rule on anything.
Okay, but
all right.
But I'm just asking that.
And I'm telling the answer is I don't know. I don't have anything in front of me to look at or to make a decision on. I don't have a motion. I don't have a document.
But that document was included in the OII that the commission released.
But no one's moving it into the record.
Well, the OII is in the record.
The OII is filed. Whatever is in the OII in a public document is public.
Right, but all I'm saying, Your Honor, is that that was included with the OII, signed by all the commissioners, and that was a document that was included, and it was a finding of the NRC. And I'm just asking so that we can cut through, if that seems to be the issue, that it was a design and modeling problem from which all else basically rotates, then could we just make an inquiry of SCE if they intend to turn over those design and modeling documents?
You are free to pursue whatever data requests you like, and if the parties cannot agree, then it will come before me in a motion.
All right, very well.
So let it come before me in a motion, and I'll just strike it down, and you'll never get to see anything. It's all one big secret, one big control game. We're just the eaters. And what really, truly amazes me is that there is little to no, there is little to no coverage about these proceedings, about these hearings, in the newspaper. And there is a complete media blackout about anything that has to do with songs. Anything. The only place you're going to see and find out what's going on with this is alternative media channels on the internet. That's basically it. So, as always, chin up, and God bless. At least we have each other.
Mr. Weissman,